Hello students, welcome back to my class. Today I am going to teach you English grammar. As you know that I am teaching class 6, that's why I am going to teach you English grammar of class 6. The chapter name is voice, and if the chapter name is voice, you must already know that we are going to talk about active ends. Passive voice means our topic is active voice and passive voice, or you can also say that our topic is changes of voice. So first of all, because this is the first time that you are going to study, you are going to read voice, that's why first of all you have to understand what is active voice and what is passive voice. When the verb shows that the subject does the action, the verb is said to be in the active voice. For example, Ram hits the ball. Here hit is the verb, simple present tense. I have just taught you tenses, and in tenses I told you how can you recognize a tense. So this is simple present tense, and the sentence is Ram hits the ball. Subject is Ram. So this subject does the action, this subject does the action, ये काम जो है ये action subject ही कर रहा है, that's why it is in active voice. Now come to the second example, the boys made a kite. The boys is the subject, and this action made, this is done by, directly done by the subject, that's why it is in active voice. The tense is simple past tense, because this is the second form of main verb, that's why the tense is simple past tense. So the boys made a kite, in this sentence the action directly done by the subject, that's why this is in active voice. Now come to the second point. The second point is passive voice. Second one, passive voice. When the verb shows that the subject receives or suffers the action, when subject doesn't do the action but receives or suffers the action, the verb is said to be in passive voice. So when the verb shows that the subject receives or suffers the action, the verb is said to be in passive voice. If subject does the action, it is active voice. If subject receives or suffers the action, then it is passive voice. Now see how in the example, the ball is the subject, the ball is hit by Ram, the ball is hit, this is the verb, and the verb shows that the action is not done by the ball but somebody else, the action is done by somebody else, it means the subject receives the action. This subject receives the action, this subject done the action. Here in active voice the subject done the action, in passive voice the subject receives the action from the verb. This is the basic difference between active voice and passive voice. Active voice mein kya hota hai, subject khud kaam karta hai. Passive voice mein kya hota hai, jo kaam hota hai usko receive karta hai, usko jo hai पाता है, उसको जो है एक्शन से सफर करता है जो हमारा सब्जेक्ट होता है. सो इफ द सब्जेक्ट डज द एक्शन, इट इज एक्टिव वाइज. इफ सब्जेक्ट रिसीव्स द एक्शन, इट इज पैसिव वाइज. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी द बॉल इज हिट बाय द राम, बाय राम. दिस एक्शन इजंट डन बाय द बॉल बट इट इज रिसीव्स ओनली द एक्शन, इट इज डन बाय समबडी एल्स, इट इज नॉट डन बाय the subject. If subject does the action, it is active voice. If subject receives the action, it is passive voice. This is the passive voice of first one. Now see the passive voice of second one. The kite was made by the boys. The kite is the subject, was made is the verb. The kite was made by the boys. The subject receives the or suffers the action. It is not doing the action. That's why it is in passive voice. There are few rules to change from active voice to passive voice. So let us first discuss about this, how to change active to change of active voice to passive voice. How can we change? There are different rules. First of all, see the rule of changing of pronoun. If here the subject is pronoun, it will be changed in passive voice according to its number and person. For example, if here will be I will be changed into me. If you is the same in subject and object. If we will be changed with us. So if the subject is we, object will be us. If the subject is I, object will be me. If the subject is he, object will be him. Like that, we will change the pronoun like that. Now come to the second one. The subject of the active voice changes with the object of the passive voice. Subject of the active voice changes with the object of the passive voice. So subject will be here and object will be here in passive voice. That's why Ram is here at the place of object and this object is here at the place of subject. You can say subject and object replace each other places. So the next one is that, and see the next one. In this we always use the third form, or you can say past participle form of main verb in passive voice. In passive voice we always use the third form or past participle form of main verb. The tenses never change when we change from active voice to passive voice. Whenever we change active voice to passive voice, the tenses never changes, but there may be a little bit changes. For example, this is present perfect, present indefinite tense, simple present tense. In simple present tense we use is, am, are as helping verb and first form, third form of the main verb. In passive voice we always use helping verb and main verb, and main verb must be in third form, or you can say past participle form. Topic is change of voice. How can we change from active voice to passive voice? We will change the voice from active voice to passive voice according to the tenses. So first of all, simple present tense. How can we change if a sentence is in simple present tense from active voice to passive voice? See the rule. If the sentence is simple present tense, we will write in passive voice first of all subject, then is, am, are according to the subject, then past participle, or you can say third form of the main verb, then by agent, and then object. This is the rule to change in simple present tense from active voice to passive voice. So see the example. Mohan writes a book. This is the subject, this is the verb, and this is the object. And I told you earlier that we will change, exchange, replace subject and verb, object with each other. The object will take the place of subject and the subject will take place of the object in passive voice. So now the subject in passive voice will be a book. So a book is the subject. Now we have to see, is the subject singular or plural? Subject is singular. With singular subject we will use helping verb is. With plural subject we will use helping verb are. With I we will use helping verb I. So the subject is singular. That's why we will use a singular verb and the singular verb is. So is, and we have to see the verb. The verb is write, and I told you that we will change the verb into past participle, into third form of the main verb. So the third form of write is written, is written, and then we will write the by, then by, and we will write the subject as object in passive voice. So the object in passive voice is Mohan. This is the changing rule of simple present tense. Only one thing is different, otherwise the changing rule of all tenses are the same. Only there will be one difference, and the difference will be helping verb. Helping verb, only helping verb will be differ. For example, is being, was, have been, has been, etc. So now see the second example. The second example is children pluck the flowers. Children is the subject, pluck is the verb, the flowers is the object, as you know. So as I told you, we will make the object as subject in the passive voice. So the flowers are the subject now. The flowers are subject. The subject is plural, flowers. That's why we will use a plural verb, that is are. In simple present tense, if the subject is singular, we will use is. If the subject is plural, we will use are to make the passive voice. The verb is pluck, and the third form of pluck is plucked. As it is said that we will use past participle form in passive voice. We always use past participle form in any tense. There we don't have to see which tense is this in passive voice. In passive voice, we always use the third form of main verb. Then by, and then we write the subject at the place of the object. So this is the changing rule of simple present tense. Now come to the changing rule of present continuous tense. When we change passive voice, when we change the sentence from active voice to passive voice in present continuous tense, first of all we write subject. Then according to the subject, we will write is, am, or are. And then past participle form of the main verb, then by agent, and in the last, object. As you know, the subject of active voice will be the object in passive voice. The object of active voice will be the subject of passive voice. So, see, the example, the boys is the subject, are playing verb, and cricket object. So in passive voice, we will make the object as subject. So cricket is the subject. Cricket is singular. The subject is singular, that's why we will use is. If the subject is plural, we will write are. If the subject is I, we will write am. Is, with is, I forget to join one thing. You use being. After is, am, are, we use being. Is, am, are, we use being. Cricket is being, then third form of the main verb. As I told you, in every sentence of passive voice, we always use third form of the main verb. So cricket, the object is the subject here. According to the subject is, and after the helping verb, we will use being. After being, we will change the verb, main verb of active voice, into the third form, played, and then by agent, and then the subject will be object here. Now see the next rule, next example. The next example is Kamal is reading a book. Kamal is the subject. Is reading is the verb, and a book is the object. So see, as you know, a book will be the subject in the passive voice. A book is singular, that's why we will use is. And after the helping verb, we will use being. And the main verb is read. The third form of read, the written form of read is the same, read, but pronunciation is different. For example, read, read, read. That's why here it is read. Is being read by Kamal. After that, after the main verb in third form, we will write by agent. After by, we will write the subject as object in passive voice. This is the changing rule of present continuous tense. Now my class is over for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.